Okay guys, so this is the finished dresser. I really like how it came out. It definitely wasn't what I was intending to begin with. To begin, I was just gonna paint it white, but what happened was after I painted the base of it, I ran out of time and I put the brown knobs, the brown drawers back in just to leave the house for a bit. And I like the contrast of the color, so I decided to paint the drawers a different color than the body of the dresser. And I decided to go with pink so that it matched her bedroom decor, and I really liked the way that the color came out. The knobs as well was an unexpected DIY. I was looking for the little diamond knobs at the hardware store, and they were really expensive. They were like $5 a knob, or like 8 for 16 or something. That it wasn't as expensive, but I was still not willing to pay that much, especially since I didn't really find anything wrong with the original ones. I just wanted to find something girly. So I accidentally bumped into these little sticker decals at the dollar store. And then I thought, okay, let me paint the original knobs and then just put these little stickers on it. And it definitely makes it look like the diamond knobs that you get at the store. So yeah, that's what I did. And then the middle ones actually had knobs as well, but I just didn't like the fact that it had three knobs on each dresser. So I took out the middle ones and I used some of the other decals for the middle, which I thought made it really, really cute. And then the bottoms as well, I just added rhinestones around them just because I found that it was a bit too plain, especially with these three all jazzed up. So I bought some rhinestones to just put around the borders. So these rhinestones at the top, a pack was $1.25, and then I got two packs of these bigger rhinestones at the bottom for $2 each at the dollar store. And they're pretty cute. Like, I like how it turned out. It definitely wasn't what I was looking for, but it plays into her room really, really well. And I'm happily surprised by the outcome. It definitely looks like one of those expensive dressers that you would buy at the store or whatever. And all I did was refurbish an old one that we had in the house. One piece of advice I would give is that to use a foam roller. As you can see in the video, I used a regular fuzzy house roller, which didn't work well. And then I used a regular brush, which I hated because you could see the brush strokes. And most people, they say if you use the brush, you can sand it down and then keep painting it with the brush. But I didn't want to sand anything, to be honest. And as you can see, at the top, there's a bit of an imperfection, which you could easily sand down and repaint. But I just didn't want to be bothered with it. So I used a foam roller, which worked really, really well, and it gave it a great finish. So I definitely recommend using a foam roller when you're painting furniture if you're not going to spray paint. And yeah, I really like the outcome. It was really, really great. I think this matches her room really well. And the color of it is more of that bubblegum pink instead of that hot pink down there. I think it's just the lighting in the room that's just making it a bit off. But yeah, so that was it for the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And subscribe if you haven't. And like this video if you want more of this content. See you later. Bye.